Just went with that clear right there, but still have two more turns. Here comes Aaron, another shot. Oh, he got there. He forced him up the track a little bit. Side by side, who's Reed gonna go with? Reed's going with the outside. No, he's not. He fakes it. Thompson gets past. Aaron Abel versus Sergi Thompson. Coming off the final corner. Who got there? Coming at the checkered flag. It's going to be Sergi Thompson gets the run off the outside. And he will win the preseason 50.
It's too far for me to fall. To get back up and shake it off. And this time my page has got to turn. What fool did you take me for? Like I couldn't walk through an open door. And this time I'm finally gonna learn that if a heart is kind, it's never gonna make it. Cause you are in disguise and sure gonna break it. Just like a chemical weapon, yeah.
With just over, like, what is that? Oh, we're at 20 laps to go, so he's definitely got a shot. We're going to be the first Pontiac to win. I don't think we have a single Pontiac win, as Thompson's going to go for the lead now, but Tom will lead that lap. 5 bonus points for him. By the way, I don't think a Pontiac has ever won, because there's only like 4 or 5 Pontiacs in this whole series. Tom is one of them, so has damage. Wait, he got a 3.5-second lead on his teammate. They're off the last 4. The worn tires beat the fresh tires this time. Sergi Thompson is the first rookie ever to win on the ShopRite series, and it comes right away.
He's right behind Landon. Reed's doing everything in his power to block, because Thompson was too fast. And Reed is losing time. Shutting and Jimmy Reed are behind him. They're side by side, and Reed will take the fourth spot away from Reed. They're side by side as they head into the last turn. Can he clear the 86? It's getting tight. They're side by side still. Thompson clears and he'll take the lead. We know that Talladega earlier this year. Thompson on that rocket. They're coming into the next turn. Second to last, we'll move behind him. Coming in the final turn. Yeah. Kevin Thompson out in front. He's going to be able to hold the lead as he comes out the final turn. Sergi Thompson will win.
Sergi Thompson's championship goals are probably cemented in legacy here. He probably is going to cement his championship with his 3rd win of the season and of his career. Sergi Thompson wins at Kansas by a 6/10 lead. Shuffled back, bro. I don't want you to kill everyone. Probably going to get a decent. What are the odds of this garden? No caution. Oh, Owen Smith's dead. Smith. Oh, shoot. Bro, what is this track, bro? Bro, what is this track? And they wrecked in front of them after that. I saw that. Parsons dead. Freaking die. We have only 20 cars left. 19 on lead lap. That's slow. This green flag is out there. What for team? Drake.
Say it anyway.
After moving to a new his first shot. It comes in the 2004 cover from the 60s.
Coming for your love, okay.
Jimmy Reed's in second. Green Flag comes out from Rutherford, who leads the series. He leads the series in top 10s. He has 17 top 10s. The record last year, Byron got 19 top 10s. The only one who had more than 12. So Aaron Abel's going to immediately get past this. Plays on his pedigree behind him. There goes Luke Anderson. Sorry, I didn't do this. Lap 28 has brought out what everyone's used to. Atlanta Motor Speedway in the ShopRite series. Fred takes a ridiculous looking tumble. Cameron Regal did one of the most greatest record races of the decade. Oh my goodness, Fred with a wild ride. There, always in the background. Crazy tumble. Rutherford could be inside, side by side, battle for the lead. That's going to allow those guys to reel them in if they can't pass each other. Groppy has a huge chance at catching those guys now. 208 miles an hour, my goodness. Donnie Sauter had the fastest lap by a... Wow, that's a big interval. Rutherford got one career victory in a Wreckfest Coca-Cola 600. He's finally won. Now this was a Wreckfest simply talented song. Race looks like in my laptop. Chris is behind the four. He's gonna go for the lead. Ooh, Drive goes for third on Roadie. So can the four keep it straight? He clears the 45, but he doesn't have enough run off the final corner. Christopher Abel is going to make this record even longer. 14 different winners this season. He gets his first win this season, his third career win. It comes at Pocono.
Third at the back, really, actually. As you see, these cars just kind of string out in the back here. I don't know why. Especially because they're probably a big shit show. I don't know why he's in here. It's that. Oh, okay. That happened. But some of these cars will have new paint schemes this year. And next year, sorry. So, keep it down. There goes Rick. The palace upside down. There goes Reed. And that's what they were waiting for. The palace is barrel rolling. And Reed into Thompson. Looks like the palace lands on all fours. And they're wrecking up here as well. JJ Sauter and Jordan. Uh-oh, and here comes the lap to wrap it. Grogu is going to get split. And now he's rolling Drake. And Christopher Abel is going to be taking the lead away from Kyle Robinson. Yes, he got Dario Sanchez also coming out. So they're going to go around him with ease. This holds the lead now. We come off the final corners. Abel holds it. Monroe stays in behind him. There goes Abel at the bottom. He holds it, and Chris Grable will win the Bucksy 400. Elliot Monroe comes in second, Kyle Reddington in third. For back-to-back wins, he's won back-to-back races before. Him and Roddy side-by-side, into the wall! Leaders around! Drew's getting turned, and hit hard by Jet Li. Huge wreck! Cars are down, Byron is dead, Arch. Oh my goodness, everyone now is down. Out. So DeConte out in front. But here comes Joey Dry. Oh, there they go. Oh, almost right there. Three wide is just straight against the bottom. Oh, he's just DeConte spinning. He's kind of later than that left. He's going to the 10 going to go with this for middle lane. What the heck? He's 21 5. Oh, crap, he's in the wall. And slaying here in the second, looking like the last take of the race. Those guys finished 1-2 as well. Kelvin Bronk, I don't know. Are you re-witnessing one of the greatest performances this season? Or can JoJo make a pass? Come in, turn 3 and 4 for the final time. Here comes JoJo to the inside. Trying to push the 18 up. He's not falling for the bait. He's the final corner. JoJo's the first driver in ShopRite Series to sweep a track. And to sweep a track from the pool. Chris Grable has done it. He has accomplished the impossible by Ricardo. What a good block by the rookie here.
He's had tons of experience because of all the craziness that's happened this year. But here comes the 18B inside the 23. Able will take that spot unless the 23 can get a good run on turn 4. 23 slides up high. He's going to be staying only 59 laps. In so much, but he just didn't have enough time. They're gonna wreck. Oh my, there they go. Oh, oh, that's a watch him bow up in the back.
I'm a bullet from a gun in my heart is a trigger.
That is definitely not a good sign about home.
When I was just a kid, I was dreaming I was bigger. If you wanna make a name, better stand and deliver.
Come out. That's Sonoma. 23 laps. Shelby Howard leads. Man is like sitting 40th in points. He has a DNP, but he has a few goals. Let's see if he can take advantage of his track position. The Byron's going to get out of the city. Keep rising up. Oh, can't stop me now. I'm going to pull up. Oh, can't stop me now. ShopRite series driver in history to win a race by leading every single lap. Asher Byron wins at Sonoma. Turner has.
Anyway, Art's gonna steal some spots as well. He's gonna get around his teammate and maybe Aaron Abel. Oh, 14 tried a nice block there. Couldn't get there though. Slides way high. Regal's gonna get that spot as Jimmy Smith, obviously. They're gonna split him. And the 7 clears him and will keep his second position. Now it's gonna fall Art as he got around Byron. Byron definitely got stopped there. Look at this year. 10 races, almost 11. Art going for the lead! Bulldozer takes the lead with just 15 laps to go now. And this could definitely be what the rest of this team needs behind them. Byron's looking for third now in the RT race. Those two both have top 2. Two laps to go here at Richmond. Jerry Smith leading. Logos are right behind him. Those guys, both previous race winners. Brody steals third behind them. 2 seconds back. Come with a white flag. Art's gonna go to the inside. Forces the 24 up high. White flag is out. One lap to go for Logos Art now. He takes the lead from the 24. Logos Art. Won last year in the first Dover race. Finished second in points. Comes off the final call. Logos Art gets his second goal. And then it comes at Richmond. For Jerry Smith. Art will lead us to the green as Sales. It's like he was able to continue to lead that lap. Oh my goodness, what the heck was that? Yes, Tom Sloan's gonna go for the three wide with the lap car in front of Adam Beverly. Tom Sloan's gonna take the lead. They're still hooking onto each other. And here comes Sloan's teammate Reese Brown going for seven. Sales is back on track, and he's being crazy right now. I don't know what happened. Sloan continues to hold the lead, but here comes his teammate Reese Brown behind him in second. Oh my goodness, this is getting tight. Beverly and Sales making contact, and the wall round goes to 45. Brown getting turned, another bad luck wreck. Doesn't get hit. At least, that's good. Usually gets destroyed. Sloan going to run up the corner. Are trying to sweep Richmond. His only other win came right over last year, the first Richmond race. From the first Richmond race this year. Another white flag though. White flag is out. One lap to go for Little Dart. He's all by himself, over 3 seconds in front of Rhodey. Chris Frabel is not the only one this year. He's the first, but he won't be the only one. Lolo Zart comes off the final corner, and he will sweep Richmond from 2004. He wins. Rhodey will hold on to second over Tom Sloan. Vega looking for his first laps. Kelvin almost got turned right there, and Grogu, and it does by Sales. Four wide at Martinsville, and they just die. Where is the caution? He's on the inside of Brown. Coming off the final corner, will Brown get the run? Off the final corner, Tom Sloan gets his first career win at Martinsville. Off Reese Brown. Reese just slipped up off that corner.